Welcome to the lecture number 29 of the machine learning course. In this session, we are going to talk about reinforcement learning, a very interesting topic. We are going to talk about reinforcement learning in this particular session. So the basic idea is this, that into the ML, what is our objective? Our objective is this, that the machine should learn. We should not tell the machine that what to do. So in this particular scenario, automatic learning is a very important part. So whenever we say that it is ML, ML means we actually refer that the system is going to learn by itself. I am not going to program the system. So system is going to do experiment. How can he do that? He can do the experiment, trial and error. So basic idea about the ML is actually the trial and error. Whenever we talk about the ML kind of systems. So this is not a new thing, a very old concept, that when Arthur Samuel actually wanted to build a checker playing program, and he actually had the same idea that I'm not going to program the system. Program should have some component that they are going to explore, and by doing playing multiple games by itself, the program should be able to design a best strategy for doing the this particular task. So around 1962, the same kind of system was able to be, they were able to build a system which won over the human player. And therefore, Arthur Samuel is called as a father of machine learning. He defined the machine learning as a field of study that gives the computers the ability to learn without explicitly being programmed. So without explicitly being programmed is an important line here. And that actually is a very much driving factor, that when we devise a machine learning based ML based system. So you know that when we want to develop these kind of system, we are doing this in the hope that the system is going to be intelligent. And we know that one of the very important thing that we say that these things are intelligent is a games. So whenever we want to make this kind of system, it is best to show on the games that the system is going to have the intelligence. Because you know that if there is a game, it requires some intuition, creativity, strategic thinking. There should be some strategy to win. So all these things are involved into the intelligence, and these things are also involved into the game. So multiple, you know that there are multiple efforts people have done to develop these kind of systems, such as Atari, chess, and Go. So you also know that in the future, into the future, we are going to make a more general system, that a single system would be able to play all these kind of game. But however, there were times when the people were building a specific system, such as Deep Blue, for playing chess games, and that have got around 1997. He was able to defeat the Garry Kasparov, who was supposed to be the best player at that particular time. So out of the game series, I think 3, 4, 5, 6 game series, I think two were won by the computer, and one were won by the Garry Kasparov. 3 matches were draw. But even then, since you know that draw, you can neglect one lose and 2 win means ultimately the win. And that's why the Deep Blue was actually appreciated. The better program was actually came into around 2016, when the game program was named as a AlphaGo Go, who actually defeated the Lee Sedol, who was a very high-level professional player for the Go. The story is very interesting. There is a movie also that released very soon. You may go and see that. So out of 5 game series, the computer was able to win 4 matches. Okay, computer was able to win 4 matches. One match he actually lost. And even that much he lost because of, there is something called the freshness, and in which there is a probability associated with the choosing a move that is actually bad. You know that if there are multiple moves available, and you see that there is some move that has a very, very low probability. For example, this particular move has a winning probability 0.9. This move has 0.00001 winning probability. So what move you would go? You would go for this particular move because it's a very high probability, but this move also has some probability and it is not zero. So there is a possibility that this event can also happen. In the case when this event happens, the things becomes bad. So suddenly in one match, this kind of event happens, and that's why the computer got lost. But this is not going to be a frequent phenomena. This is going to be a rare phenomena only. That's why out of the five matches, the computer was only computer had lost only one game. So let's assume that you are going to build a system that is going to learn by itself doing something that how to play and how to do with the systems. So this kind of system, so what you want to learn, okay? So there are two things that you can learn. One thing, that what is the rule of the game, means how you play these kind of games. What is the rule for that thing? Okay, one thing is that how you play this kind of game, and another thing that you want to learn the tactics, means what is the strategy that which you want to play the game. So you know that the rule is not that important, because rule may be written and finding out the rule is not that difficult. So your objective would be to learn the tactics. So whenever you are going to train a ML-based system for doing these kind of tasks, you actually want the computer to learn the strategies, tactics, that how to be good at this particular game. So with this objective, let us understand that how you can fulfill this kind of objective. So there is a very important term that is called the conditioning. So if you do a conditioning, then you can obtain these kind of things. What do I mean by this? So in this example, you can see that there is a dog, and if the food is given to him, his salivation actually started. Okay, so there is a salivation that is started. So if you give him the food, salivation is started. So the question is this: if I ring a bell, whether the salivation would start? The answer is no, because if you ring a bell, the salivation would not start. But I'm going to do the conditioning, means what? That whenever I'm going to give him a food, I'm also ringing a bell. What would happen? That if this happens every day, that before giving him the food, I'm going to ring a bell and then I give you the food. If I do it every day, then what would happen? That one day when I would ring a bell, and even if I don't give him the food, his salivation gets started. So you may think that what is going to happen, what is important, what is the main ingredient of this particular problem? The problem is this, that I wanted to make the system to react on the bell, and that's why I use this reward. What is the food? Food is a reward. I use a reward. So if you couple the reward with your actions, then you can lead to the learning. So rewards can lead to the learning. That's the important thing. So if you get a reward, then you are going to do the learning. Let us talk something more about the reinforcement learning. So this kind of systems, when actually they by themselves explore the system and do the learning, and this kind of system is called the reinforcement learning. And let me tell you that basically, to best of my understanding, these are the systems that people ever thought that they are going to be the ML system. So ML, the basic understanding was ML was actually the reinforcement learning type of system only. Okay. They works on generate and test methodology. They think that I'm going to do this thing, and then they get some reward, and they test it whether this particular thing is good or bad. Same thing means if you are going to multiple play and games, and in every game you are going to see that if I'm going to do this, what is going to happen? And when multiple things you explore, then you are going to find out that what is the best method. Here, important thing is that we assume there is some because there is a, we are going to assign a kind of notion of intelligence. So we think that there is something that is going to own this kind of intelligence, and I'm going to call it as int. So it may be a software component that is actually going to own this kind of thing. So that isn't is going to learn. Okay, so how he learns, as I told you, that generate and test means what? He enumerates all the possible things. He thinks that I can do all these things, so he has to generate that what I'm going to do, and then for every kind of action he is going to compute that how much reward he is going to get. So multiple things are possible some rewards are different. So you know that he would choose this particular action because here the reward is high. He would learn in this particular way. Important point is this, that in some kind of game settings, the reward could be indirect, and directly you cannot get that, maybe delayed. So if this kind of scenario can also happen, what do I mean by this? So you know that in the game of chess, if you are playing something, so for example, if you are forwarding a particular thing to in the forward or backward, whatever situation, if you are changing the board position, so ultimately you are going to win or lose or draw. But right now, whether you are going to see that what is going to happen, answer is no. When the game would end, then you would be able to know that what has happened and what is your reward. If it is a lose, you get zero. If it is a draw, you get one. If you win, you get 2 points. So what you are going to get, sometimes you may not directly, immediately can see that what is going to happen. After some time, it is going to happen. So the reward could be delayed. This is what the point is. Here we are assuming that the agent that we are going to have does not have any prior knowledge. So he starts with a zero knowledge, and does the exploration, and then at the end he find out that what is the right thing to do. So there is a very important segregation between the learning system. Sometimes you say that some systems are supervised and unsupervised. So if I ask you that whether reinforcement learning is supervised or unsupervised, so answer is this, that this is not neither supervised and supervised nor unsupervised. Why? Because right answer are not given. But when he does a trial, then he find out that what is the right thing to do. So it is a new kind of learning paradigm where we say that it is a trial and error kind of learning strategy. Okay. So it is something related to the dynamic programming, because he wants to explore all the things. You know that in dynamic programming, you explore all the possibilities and take the answer. So it is related to the dynamic programming, means all the solutions, see, by doing the trial and error, it explores all the possibilities and then learns that what to do next. There are various examples where you can apply this thing. We have known that the game playing is one of them. Robot control, learning to optimize operations, and playing various boards, games, etc. You can apply all these kind of methods over there. So let us go and try to be some technical and try to understand some of the things that actually can be done with this. So let us understand these topics, these things. What is a state? What is action? What is reward? So we are going to understand this into this way, that let's assume that there is an environment. In this environment, there is an agent. Agent is something that is going to learn. He want to perform some kind of actions on that, okay? Because this is your learning agent. He want to perform some of the action on the environment. So for example, let's assume that game of chess. What is the environment? Environment could be the various board positions. What could be the environment? Board position. So you think that all the board positions are there, but no, try to understand. Environment is if I say that environment could be, out of all these board position possibilities, environment would be into one state, because if you are going to play the move, so one board position would be there. Do you understand this? Possibility is this, that any board position could be there, but you are at a particular time, you would be into one board position. Okay, so agent would try to understand that what is the state. State means what? That what is the board position. Okay, so agent first perceives that what is the state of the thing. So first thing is the state. Everybody understand the state? Any questions on that? As I told you that into the game of chess or into the similar way for others also, board position are the possible environment state. So any particular time the environment would be into one state. So in agent want to understand that what is the state. So let's assume that he discovers that this is the state he have, because when opponent have offered him to do a move, he sees that what is the board position. then he does the action because he have to advance the move. He is having a move. So what is the action? That out of all available things, he picks a particular item and advances it. So this is what the action is. So after doing this action, what would happen? That the environment would get changed from one state to another state. So if the things are going to change, he would be getting a reward. If it is going to change, then he will be getting reward. So maybe sometime reward could be zero also, because when the game is going on, then he may not be getting the reward. But at the end, when the game finishes, at that time, he would be getting some reward, maybe 0, 1, or 2. So sometimes rewards are 0, sometimes rewards are 1, sometimes rewards are 2 into the game of chess. You understand? So this is the overall scenario. So here you may connect into this particular way, that we assume that this initially there is some initial state. Agent is taking an action and therefore the state changes, because you know that the board position changes. This gives him a reward, R0. Then he does, in this state, he again takes another action, he gets another reward. In this new situation, he again takes another action, another reward. For S3, he keeps doing this until the game finishes. Make sense? All right. The goal is, learning goal is to choose a policy that maximizes the reward, because we want to find out a policy. So here the policy is a very important term, that he want to learn a policy. He want to learn a method. Policy is a method. What the policy says, try to understand, that if I give you a board position, then your policy, let me call it by pi, given this board position, this is going to give you that what action you should take. Okay, action A. It replies a action A. Any question on that? If I give you a board position, then this policy is going to give you a board position. So a action that you have to take on this particular board position. Okay. So ultimately your objective would be to, because ultimately your objective would be to win. So you want to maximize something. What is that thing? So let's assume in this particular way that you are into this particular state, and there are various action possible, that you know that what are the action possible. Out of them, you have to pick one, which one you should pick. This is what the question is. And policy is going to tell you that which action you are going to have. So this method actually says that you have to choose a policy that maximizes the rewards. So what is the reward? So because if you take this particular action, for example, let me choose this particular action. If you take this particular action, you may be getting a reward of R. I don't know. Let's assume that you are going to get the reward R0. But after this also you have to play the game. Na? You are not going to stop at this particular moment. You will be again taking some move. And here you would be getting, and let's assume that after that you pick this particular way and you reach to this particular state. Here also again you have to take various actions are possible. Out of them you have to pick one action. So every time here, let's assume that you got the reward R1, here you got the R2, here you keep getting the reward at later point of time. So let's create a formulation that tells that right now I'm going to get the R0. So this is the R0, but after that thing, because right now I am going to focus on this particular state only. I am in this particular state, I have one action I have to take. But I also have to understand that, let's assume that this is the highest one, this is giving me the highest reward, but after that, I would be into the bad shape. So is it a right strategy? Answer is no. You have to see that at the later point of time, what is going to be best. So if at the later point of time, rewards you are going to get, R1, R2, R3. So you can say that how much you are going to give the importance to them. Let's assume that I put another parameter also. I say that gamma multiplied by reward at that time, gamma square reward, gamma cube reward, plus dot, 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 infinite. So until your game finishes, you are going to see that what are the rewards that you are going to get at later point of time. And you are going to multiply with the factor gamma. Gamma is just a parameter. If I say that gamma is equal to 0, means what? All these things goes away. So I say that I'm going to only focus on the what I got immediately. If I put gamma is equal to 1, means everything is going to be given the equal importance. If the gamma is equal to, if the gamma is equal to 1, means what? All these things R1, R2, R3. Means this is a general formulation which actually gives you the to choose the value of appropriate gamma, by which you say that everything is equally important. If I put the gamma is equal to greater than this, for example, gamma is equal to 2 means things which are going to come are very much important and these things are lesser important. So therefore, this gamma parameter actually gives us a general formulation where we say that if we want to maximize this particular thing. Okay. However, having the gamma greater than 2, greater than 1 doesn't make much sense because what are the things going to come? They are not going to be seen at this particular moment. So that is actually sometime going to be absurd kind of thing. So it is good to see that gamma, the value of gamma is going to be between 0 and 1. And this is a quantity that you want to maximize any particular point of time. Once again, any question on that? So what I wanted to tell you once again, let me tell you. I think this is a very important point that you should understand. At this particular moment, at any particular moment, there are various options available. These options are going to give you the reward R0. So multiple, for example, here the reward is 10, here the reward is 20, here the reward is 5, here the reward is 11, here the reward is 90. So which you would like to choose? You would like to choose this particular path where you are going to get the reward 90. But if I tell you that later, if you go forward, you would be getting only 0 rewards after that. And here, every time you are going to reward, get 5. Here, every time you are going to reward 9. Here, every time you are going to reward 10. Here, every time you are going to reward 20. Then what is the strategy? So definitely, you would not choose this 90. Maybe other. Which other? That we have to find out based on using the formula. And we say that, let's assume that, let's fix that how much importance you want to give to the items which are going to become later, and based on that you find out this thing. So you are going to choose choose that particular action which maximizes this. So your policy that you are going to learn would be such that actually this kind of maximization, that it itself does the maximization and give you the appropriate action that maximizes particular quantity. Understand? Okay. So as I told you, that policy is going to be pi, that given a state gives you that what action you should take. There are some assumptions that reward is delayed, means what is the reward at that time may not be directly available. Exploration, your agent is going to decide, he is going to decide that what action he should take, maybe by randomly or whatever, he is going to do the things. So exploration is a very important part into the reinforcement learning. Partially observable state, there could be some situations when your agent is sensing the environment, he may not get the complete picture. He may be only getting the small portion of the thing. How can it is possible? So for the game of chess, it is not possible. But let's assume that you are going to have a different system where, assume autonomous car. Okay, autonomous car. Here, what would happen? That if you sense the thing, you would be able to see that what is around your car, but you don't know that what is happening far away. So environment is the complete city map. What is happening inside the city? Because if you want to navigate with a car, you have to know that what is the traffic condition and where other cars are. But only information that is available to you is what is into the nearby area. So all these things are not available. So this is called the partially observable states. Lifelong learning. It may be possible that you have to keep changing your policy as you are going. You cannot fix the things that I have fixed the things. So it may also be possible because if something changes, then you have to be able to adopt that particular system. Here, our assumption is in this particular lecture is this, that when we are going to solve this kind of problem, our assumption is this, that it is a Markov decision process. What do I mean by this? It is a Markov decision process. What do I mean by this? You know that what is the Markov process. Markov process says that if you have a kind of a string, so or any kind of phenomena is going to happen. So the last one actually describes everything. So it actually encodes everything into itself. What does it mean by this? That if you want to find out that what is going to happen next, you only see that what is here and you see that what is going to happen next. So you need not to understand that what has happened earlier. So this is the basic understanding of the Markov decision process. It says that if you want to find out the what is RT, it is going to, you just see the what is the state and what is the action, definitely you would be able to say that what is going to happen next. You need not to consider the previous thing. To find out that what is going to be your reward or what is going to be your next state, you just see that in which state you are and what are the actions that you are going to take. You will be able to find out that what is my next state. You need not to have the history. You need not to have the history. A few minutes back, we have talked about that discounted cumulative reward is this, that what is discounted. Discounted is this, that whatever things that are going to come, they are being multiplied with a factor that is gamma square and etc. So the things which are going to come, they are actually discounted, they are multiplied with a factor gamma that can be chosen less than one. So what is the most important thing is that what is immediately you are going to get, and the things which are going to come, they are going to have the lesser importance. Okay, so now we have a very interesting parameter here. If I say that V pi st, look, very important thing I'm going to tell you, that how much you can get if you are using this particular policy and you are into this particular state. So very interesting thing. For example, if you are into this particular state and multiple things are available, so this thing can tell you that how much you can get when you are into this state, how much you can get when you are into this particular state. So if you want to take the action, you just see that how much the immediate reward you are going to get plus this much. This is only the thing that you are going to get if you take this particular direction. Similarly, if you want to go into this particular direction, so this VST tells you that how much you can get after that and what is the immediate reward. You just consider these two things, then you can tell that okay, I am going to take this particular action. Understand, this is nothing more than this, that for the infinite term you are going to find out the summation. So till now we have seen one method that gives you that what is the reward, discounted cumulative reward. Instead of this, there could be other choices also, such as finite horizon reward, that tells that you know that multiple things are going to come as the time passes by. So it tells that finite horizon means you are going to see this particular distance only. After that, what is going to come, you are not going to consider them. And these things you are going to find out as a summation. So these things are actually important. So what is going to happen in nearby is important. Finite horizon reward. Average reward, it tells that you are going to this particular place, you are going, instead of using summation of this, you take the average. So whatever is going to happen to the near future, you are going to have the average and use this value as an advancing factor, that how you are going to advance. Okay, so to determine the optimal policy, your objective would be what would be that you want to find out the policy. And policy could be many, policy, this is the first policy, this is the second policy, this is the third policy, multiple policies are there. You would be picking that particular policy that gives you winning thing. What is the winning thing? That you profit is maximized. What is the profit? You know that profit is, we have few minutes back defined that how much you can get, that if you apply this particular policy, then we actually going to tell that what is the value that you are going to get when you are going to have the start. For all the states which are there, for all the going to states that are there, you want to maximize this particular quantity, means when you are going to play the game, every time you want to be advantageous in all the states. So this value should be maximum. This value should be maximum. So for all the available policies, you are going to argmax, means what? That the policy which maximizes this particular quantity. Make sense? So, and that would be one policy. That would be only one policy. And this policy is the best policy. And I'm going to call it pi star. One again. Pi is the policy. Pi star, what is the pi star? The best policy. That actually we want to find out. Okay, let me give you an example. And I think you would be able to understand. This is a very important slide that gives you the understanding of many things. So here, to give you the understanding, I have a game. And this game has only how many? Six different cells. And in this game, there is a goal state. If you are here and you enter into the goal state, you get 100. If you are here, you enter into this particular state, you get 100. But if you are here, you come, you go, if you are here, you go into this thing, you get zero. If you go here, you get zero because you are not going to the goal state, you are going somewhere else, you should get zero. Similarly, if here, you go here, you get zero. Otherwise, if you come here, you get zero. Go up, you get 100, here you get zero. In here, because nowhere there is a goal state, so if you go in any direction, you would be getting zero. Similarly here, similarly here, similarly here. So immediate, these are the immediate reward, how much reward you have. Okay. So point is this, that if you are here, you can come here, and you can come here, 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 and here. This is the one way you can reach the goal. So there could be multiple ways to reach the goal. Understand that how you should progress is going to told by whom? Policy. Policy is going to tell that if you are into this particular state, where should you, what is your action? So what are the action? Can you tell me? So action could be that you go into the left direction, you go to the down, you go to the up, you go to the right. These are the actions. These are four actions possible. Okay. These are the four actions possible. If you are into states, let me call it S1, S2, S3, S4, S5, S6. So S1, S2, S3, S4, S5, S6. These are the states. Okay. So policy is going to tell you that if you are into this particular thing, what direction you should go. So what would be the policy? I think I have to, if I want to make the policy, policy is going to give you that in this particular thing, what is the action? So S1, what is the action? It would be something like this. I'm just randomly putting something. It is going to tell you if you are into this particular state, you should take this action. This is what the policy is. Okay. So how can I decide the policy? If somebody tell me, very important part I'm going to tell. If somebody tell me that taking this direction gives you 10. Taking this direction gives you 5. Taking this direction gives you 9. Taking this direction gives you 11. So can you tell me what would be your pi? And this is what? That the maximum that you can get. Let me say V pi of S is this for a given state. If this is the value, then using this thing, immediately you can tell that looks like that this one was actually maximum. So instead of this value, I'm going to have what? This, because this is the maximum one. If somebody can give me, very important thing, if somebody can give me this table where VS values are specified, I can find out that what is the right way to go ahead with this. Okay. So let's assume somebody gives you this table that I'm talking about. So there are some dash also. Why there are some dash? If you are into the state S1, you cannot take the right. Now here you cannot take the right or up. So these things are not possible. So it is dash. For other things, if this value is given to you, then you can find out what is the optimal policy. How can? See you. Can you see this? That S1, here is a 90 and 72. So definitely you would choose what? You would choose that I would go into this particular direction. Into the S2, 181, 81. So you would pick this direction. So S3, I think S3 is not there because goal state you don't want to move. Okay. So you are not going to take any move. 81, 81, so you can take anyone. So maybe let me say that I take this up. Here 90, 72, 90. So 90, 72, 90. Okay, 90, 72, 90. Which action you are going to take? Out of anyone you can take, let's assume that I write up. 81 and 100, so you take up. So in this way, if I say that this is S1, S2, S3, S4, S5, S6, so for S1, it is like this. For S2, it is also like this. For S3, it is not going to take any action. For S4, it is going to take up. S4, it is going to take up. So you can take this also. S5, you can take up. Okay. S5, you can take up. And S6, you can take up. Here you can take up. Okay. So this is also fine. So because there were some places, there was equality. So if you consider with that, you can take this particular thing. This is the optimal policy. Everybody understand this? It tells you that in which direction you should move. If you are here, you should move here. If you are here, you should move here. If you are here, you should move here. So you similarly can find out that what are these values. Okay, so this is coming. This table is coming from V star values. If someone gives me this V star means V pi star S, somehow somebody gives me that this is the maximum that is possible. If this is maximum that is possible, if somebody gives me this, then using this thing, I can make this particular thing. Make sense? So how come this value is possible? Because here one value is only given. How can this value is possible? Once again, this is a very important table. If somebody gives me that I am going into this particular state, I go into this direction, I get 90. I go this direction, I get 72. If somebody gives me all these information, then using these informations, if somebody can give me how this value is computed, we are going to talk later. But let's assume that somebody gives me this table. All of you would agree that if somebody gives me this table, if from this state going here 90, going here 72, going here 81, going here 81, somebody gives me this particular information, then I can use this thing to find out that what is the maximum over here. What maximum I can get when I'm into this particular state? Because you know that here you can take two actions. One gives you 72, one gives you 90. Definitely, if you are a right person, then you would be taking this direction, and therefore maximum you can get is 90. You can create this particular table. Okay, if you can create this particular table, then going in that this direction is 100, going this direction is 81, definitely you would be going to this particular direction. If you are here and you know that going up is 100, going this side is 81, going this side is 100, so definitely you would go into this particular direction or up. So if this table is given to you, once again, if this table is given to you, then using this table, you can create this table that tells you that what is the maximum that I can get when I change my states. And using this thing, you can create that what is the right action I should take. This right action is the policy that actually we want to make. Everybody, are you clear? This right table is actually our policy that we want to learn. This is the policy. This how much I am going to get, that is a V star S, how much maximum I can get. And this table is important. If somebody gives me this table, and I have not talked much about this particular table, this table is called Q table. What is this table? This table is called Q table. So ultimately, once again, if a problem is given to you, your task is to create this kind of table. That table is called the Q table. If you can come up with this kind of table, that is a Q table, then everything simplifies. You can find out this V table, and using this, you can find out that what is the policy, optimal policy, or the what is the right way to move. Everybody, okay? Any questions on that till now? Atharva, do you understand this? That if a problem is given to me, what I wanted to tell, that if a problem is given to me, if somehow somebody can give me this value, that if you are taking this action, what is the advantage? In every action, somebody tell me that what is the advantage. Then using this thing, I can create that if you are into this particular state, what maximum you can get. And using this thing, then you can find out that since if you are here, if you see all these actions, and which whatever action gives you the maximum, you can take it. And therefore, you can create the policy. So important part is finding out this value. We have not talked about this. So whether this is clear, that if somebody can give you the Q value table, then you can find out the answer. Athar, is it clear? Gauranj? Yes? Okay. So you understand this particular fact that given the problem, our objective would be to find out this table. And this table is called the Q table. Let us understand this table and let us make this particular table. How can we make this particular table? So ultimately, our problem reduces to the Q learning, where we want to find out this table. And this table we are going to call the Q table. And This table actually gives you that since you can use this thing to find out V star values. So if two states are there, S1 and S2, and V star of S1 is greater than V star of S2, so you say that I'm going to take this particular action because that's a higher thing. If you want to create a policy, that is definitely you see that what is the immediate reward plus what is the maximum that you are going to get at this at the later point of time, multiply with the gamma, and you see that what is this particular value for all the possible actions that you can take, and return me that action which actually maximizes this value. Because of the R max, you are going to return me that particular action which maximizes this particular quantity. So if you are into your particular state, you want to find out what best you can do. So this is how you should do. Make sense? So Q value is actually going to be this quantity, because this quantity that you want to find out is going to be given by you the Q value, and Q of SA is going to be this thing. So Q table, once again, Q table is actually the final table that we want to make. And using the Q table, you can create the, how you can create the policy, all these things we have discussed. But if you don't have the Q table, then I'm going to call, let's assume that Q estimate table I have, and my objective is to make this as a Q table. Once again, what I told, that we want a particular table. Okay, and that is a Q table, but this table is not with us. We have to construct it. So I'm telling that you create another table that is Q hat having all the values zero, and you somehow make this table, change this table so that it becomes the Q table. So if I can do this, then if I get this, then everything is fine. Everything I can do. So how to get this particular table is my question, and I'm telling that you want this value, you don't have this value, you start by something else, that is Q hat, Q estimate, and then you utilize this to find out the right values. Okay. So this slide is nothing more than this. A few minutes back, we have just seen this, that this was equation written over here. This actually tells that if you don't have the exact values of Qs, so you are, instead of using Q values, you are going to use another table, that is Q hat, is the estimate. And using this thing, here also you are going to apply the same formula, and you are going to reach to the final value. So let me describe you more. So Q learning tells this thing, that you start by zero. As I told you, they start by all the values to be zero. You want this kind of table. You don't have this table. You create another empty table where you put all the values as what? All the values as what? All the values as what? Zero. How these values would emerge, we are going to talk about this. So this algorithm says, first stage is clear, that to make this thing, you start by zero. Clear? And then, very interesting part. In the game, you observe any random location as a starting location. Or sometime you know that into the game of chess, you know that what is the starting location. If it is not, otherwise you may start anywhere. So you go and choose the starting location. You see that what are the action possible, select an action and execute it randomly. You pick an action and execute it. So because you are starting the game, you don't know anything. So you pick any action and you execute it. You execute it and you would be able to get any reward. Use that reward to update your values by using this formula, that what is the reward that you have, and this, what is the maximum for all the possible actions. Because when you are actually, look what happens when you are into the game of chess, when let's assume that you are into this particular board position, various actions are possible. After each action, you are going to reach to this particular location. So various different board positions are there when you take the different actions. Here, very important point is this, that when you take this leap, then also various actions are possible. Out of these actions, you see that what is the maximum that you can, what is the maximum you can get. What is the maximum you can get is, as I told you, is given by a table called Q table. That table is not available, but right now you have the Q estimate table. So use the Q estimate table values that you are actually building right now. Initially, the value would be zero, but after some time, the value would come. So initially, the values are zero, but you use that thing and try to find out that how much maximum you can get over here. Understand? For all the possible actions, you see that what the maximum you can get over here. Add this with the reward that you are going to get over here, and this quantity is one quantity. And similarly, you can assume, you can evaluate for all the cases and find out that which is the maximum one. Okay, your objective would be to find out the maximum once again. So this is what it is. So I am telling this, that very important line, that when you are into this particular state, you randomly pick a action, because you right now you don't know the action, nah? So I'm telling that you randomly pick a action. If you randomly pick a action and you find out that if you come into this particular place, how much from here you can get. So this is the quantity that you are going to, this particular part actually represent that thing, that when you go into this particular state, how much maximum you are, when you take an action, you are going to get into this particular state, how much you can get from that particular state. So in this particular state, how much you can get and what is the reward right now, you use this thing to modify the value of Q table. Initially, your table would be having all the values as zero, but you know that after this update, there will be some value, some zero become some, are going to get some value. Make sense? You keep it while true means infinite amount of time, means you do it, keep doing this. There is no stopping condition over here. So ultimately, this is one of the most problematic thing over here, that infinite time you have to give it, and ultimately you would be able to convert. And that is the most problematic thing, that how can we bound the time over here? Okay, so everybody understand this thing? Once again, let me tell you that this algorithm says that initially your Q table is zero. Initially, your Q table is zero. Then you see that in what state you are. From that state, you pick any action, maybe randomly. And then you see that what is the new state that you have. In this particular state, what is the maximum that you can get? You multiply with the gamma and add it what is the current reward that you are going to get. This value you are going to update in your Q table. So initially, your Q table was, that particular cell was going to have the zero value, but now it is going to get some value. Okay, so here is an example. Let's assume that gamma is equal to 0.9, and this is what the scenario is, that you are here, okay, you are here, and you choose is that randomly that you are going to get into this particular place. Okay, so what is the reward? Let's assume that the reward here is 73. Reward here is a 73. And let's also assume that it is given to you that when you are into this new state, then reward into this side is 100, reward here is 81, reward here is 66. How it is given right now, let's assume that you are into mid of the doing something and these values are set into this particular way. So how you are going to update this value over here? This was 73. Now, what would be the new value here? Let's assume that into some such scenario, this value is 73. And you pick that you are going to take this particular action. So new value of here, that S1 a right, in this particular state, going to write, what is the new value of this? Earlier value was 72. What is the new value? Telling that into the new state, what are the all available thing and which is the maximum? You want to find out that maximum of this particular quantity. What is that maximum? 100, 81, 66. You know that the 100, 81, 66. So going to be maximum is going to be 100. It is going to be multiplied with the gamma. It is going to be multiplied with the gamma, and it becomes 90. Okay, so this value becomes 90. So whatever earlier value be there, because you know that reward, there is no reward into this particular thing. that table now we have seen that reward was only when you are going to go into the goal state, only these two places there was a reward, otherwise there were no reward. So reward was zero, and therefore the value becomes 90. So 73 becomes 90. So in this way you are going to keep modifying the thing. Here you again you can take any direction and you can keep modifying, and you are going to get the value. The question is, does this method converse? You will be getting to something that is actually final. Yes, under the certain assumptions, you have assumptions as, such as there is a Markov decision process, rewards are bounded, maximum value of the reward is bounded, agent visit every possible state's action pair infinitely often, then what would happen? That you know that when you have a Q table, we are thinking that Q table is a final table. So when you have the Q table, then if you apply this method, whether the values are going to change? Answer is no, because it has an optimal value. When the values are optimal, then it is not going to change. So you started by Q hat, but you know that maximum value is going to be Q. If you achieve this particular, if you achieve this kind of Q value, if you reach to the Q values, then the values are not going to change. So your things are upper bounded. And another thing is this, that every time when you are going to modify this thing, the things are going to increase. Okay, so what I'm going to tell, that you have a Q hat, that every time cell values are only going to increase, they are not going to decrease. And it is upper bounded by Q. So if you do multiple number of steps, ultimately you would be reached to the value of Q only. Okay. Ultimately, you would be able to reach to the value of Q only. So let us do some more formulation. So let us assume that this is the Q table. And this is some time when you are in between, into the scenario, and you don't have, because this value is different. You started because all the values were initially zero. You started from the zero. So from the zero, let's assume that after some time, these values are you are going to observe. Okay, let's assume that these values are there in your table. Let me also give you that, let's assume that this is the actual Q table. These values you want to find out. Ultimately, you want to reach to this particular values. Let me define a value delta n. That means that is going to find out that what is the term by term difference of these items. So can you tell me that what is the term by term difference? 90 and 81, difference is 10. 72 and 55, how much is a difference? So 198 difference is 2, 81 and 71 difference is 10, 81 and 31 difference is how much? 50. So similarly, you find out what is the difference of this particular value with respect to the Q table. And find out that for all the states or actions, what is the maximum value? If I find out what is the maximum value, what is the maximum difference? When you take the positive value of the Q and Q hat, what is the maximum value? Let's assume, let me call it as a delta n. This value is clear. Means you have the Q hat and you are targeting to Q. Find out that term by term, cell by cell difference. What is the maximum cell by cell difference? So there would be some cell which is going to have the maximum difference. And let me call that particular value. What is this? 50. This value is the maximum difference. Okay. What would happen next? That when you are going to modify the value, okay? So when you update these values, what is going to happen? That and try to see that what is going to happen at the time n plus 1, okay? When the time n, this was the difference. At the time n plus 1, what is going to happen? You know that what is this quantity? You know that what is the quantity? It, by definition, it is r plus gamma time maximum of all the action s dash a. What is this quantity? With the same way, what is the reward? Gamma time maximum of Q S dash A. Here the Q bar is there, here Q is there. Okay. So you know that because there is a difference, these values get cancelled. This gamma can be taken out. You can find out what the maximum of Q bar SA minus Q S dash A dash. So here, two sets you can think, because these are the two sets, and you want to find out the difference between them. So it would be, if I take the difference between the corresponding items and take the mod over here, and find out what the maximum value. This value would be greater than this particular quantity. So this is a larger value, because if I take this things inside, it is going to be a larger value. Okay, if I say that, because S dash is a fixed state, I say that for all the possible states, I'm going to find out this value. So as I'm telling that, we were only focusing on a particular cell. Now I'm going to tell that for all the possible cells, what is the maximum difference? So for all the possible cells, if I go and find out what the maximum difference, that would definitely be a larger quantity than this particular quantity. So this is the same kind of quantity you have seen over here, same kind of formulation that you have seen over here. Let me call it that delta. Okay, because for all the values, all the actions, what is the maximum value? Okay. So this is the same thing. So I say that this is the delta n, and this is multiplied by gamma. Okay, hold on. What do I mean by this? That initially your error was delta n, but after one step, it becomes gamma time delta n. So what would happen after next step? Gamma square delta n. This error would keep coming whenever you are going to execute one complete step. And one complete step is this, that your system is going to pass with all the states. Okay, your system has actually passed with all the states. So after that, error is going to reduce. So what would happen? That the difference between, what is this? This is the difference between, so earlier, maximum difference, just see here. Maximum difference, I'm going to talk about the maximum difference, okay? So maximum difference was here, it was 50, then maximum difference becomes 40. What does it mean? That this value would increase, some value would increase, this value would definitely increase, so that the difference is 40 and there would be minimum difference is 40. After multiple steps, when this minimum difference is 5 only, so you can see that all the values would be nearly similar, okay? Because maximum difference is 5. If when it becomes zero, means what? That all the values are going to be same. So since after one iteration, and in one iteration, I'm going to say that when the system is going to pass with all the states, error reduces from delta n to gamma delta n. So in this particular way, you can think that from gamma delta zero, you start by the whatever error you have, then it becomes gamma delta zero, gamma square delta zero, it keep doing. So ultimately it is going to be very negligible and become zero. So this is the proof that it converges, very important thing. Okay. So last thing that I wanted to discuss with here, that this method actually says that you are going to be into this particular state, and then you randomly take an action, and then you here randomly take an action. It's a kind of random walk, you perform random walk. When you move with all the states, then this is one iteration. And after one iteration, your error reduces from delta to delta gamma time delta zero. And after multiple such iteration, the error would become zero. You can see that it is going to take very large time. So what is the better way to do that? One question is this. Sometimes you may think that can I select the action that maximizes this particular quantity? The answer is no, because if you are going to do that, then at this particular place, every time you would be good at any particular state, because if you go to the maximum size, then you are not going to the other states. So one complete iteration would only be completed when you visit all the states. So definitely your probability of visiting all the states becomes less. So this is not a right strategy. What is the right strategy? Sometimes you can say that I would be with a very high probability I would go into this direction. Another direction I'm going to go with a less direction, less probability. So that could be possible. But you cannot tell that the probability of the other actions are going to be zero. So this is a better strategy. You say that in this state, you say that what maximum you can get into the next state. And based on the amount, you are going to say that with this probability, I'm going to go into that particular direction. If you go into this particular way, your conversion would be fast. Make sense? So I would stop at this particular point today. So this is today we have seen that how we can build the queue things very effectively. So there are a few slides left that are about the non-deterministic thing we would talk about into the next class. Thank you very much. Thank you for joining.